The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman. This is the Tiger Technician's Hour. My pleasure to be here. Of course, my opening call is my daily newsletter. And let's go straight to the market, which is down 243 points in the Dow, 16,035. S&P is down 27 at 1910. Comp index is down 77 at 46.75. Now, this is very interesting because finally you've got a really strong move in gold. You've got gold up 22 at 11.53. Silver's up 0.30 cents. Remember the other day we were looking at silver holding a little better than gold, and now all of a sudden they're in sync at 15.09. Platinum's up 20 at 952. You've got high-grade copper at 2.29. That's not that good. Crude oil is up 20 cents at 44.68. Now, this is going to be very interesting because bonds were up $2. They're up a dollar and 25 ticks at 157 and 13. What is important about this is if money continues to flow out, to migrate from the safe, so-called safety of bonds, into stocks, that's saying one thing. When money comes out of stocks and goes into the so-called safety of bonds, that says at this particular point, there is enough nervousness to suggest that people are looking for the security, the safety of something that they consider to be, historically speaking, meaning over the last many years, a safe haven. Even if there's no money to be made on the upside, at least your money's there. Now, it depends what you put it in, because bonds can fluctuate just like any other instrument. Now, what's also very important at this particular point is right now, as we're speaking, at 1900 on the S&P futures, the December futures down 28, exactly here is where we should see a rally. If there isn't a rally at this particular point, taking us into at least the 1905 to the 1910 level. I've got a Chapman wave trend gauge flashing from yesterday that suggested there should be some kind of a counter trend bounce, and that bounce should be as much as 7 to 9 points in the futures. If that is not possible now, I can go into the next scenario. And the next scenario says the left side, right side price tie match in the E-minis to the low bar of 1890.25 on the 1st of September. We've gone to a low today of 1897.25. So 1897. So we're 7 points away from testing that. The arch formation in the 120-minute chart of the E-minis shows you that we've got a price extension, and the low that came in yesterday lower than the 1919 round number low that had that really strong rally up to 2011.75, the 17th of September, starting on the 10th, gave that all back, and then some, and then there was a very strong bounce, but it was only that. The characteristic that I call the single leg A phenomenon. That means there is markets go in straight lines or arches or cups. Those are formations. You can see it right here. Cup formation, arch formation, arch formation. What's happened here is that you're testing the 1823 low of the 6th is really important. Why? Because we have a price time match that says you've got until noon on the 25th, what's today, 24th, at noon tomorrow, this time tomorrow, to test that 1823 level, number one. Number two is the stochastic is not quite in the buy territory, but it's getting real close at 19%. And the MACD is holding really well. There are two things about this. When the MACD holds quite well, it suggests either that there's enough strength to rally, but it also says you've got a limited rally if it flattens out. It also says, oh, man, you've now got all that room to go down if you fail to rally. So that's why this is a really a pivotal moment. Right here at 11:15, 11-11 on the 24th of September, Eastern Time, that is. Now, let's look at this. I'm going to move this away. Look at this. This pattern here is very important. When we are looking at the Dow, I-N-D-U, and you look at the way the 200-period exponential moving average was a repellent at peak D in the, let me just put that in there, right? There's the D. I haven't updated this chart. That implies that there are a couple of things that are going on. And I've got a really important call I'm going to take, and all I'm going to do is say, Sam called, is doing real well. They are. So that's just someone who had a sudden spell last night and wasn't well at all. And we were very worried and got the news that he called to say he's doing great. And I just want to let my wife know who just called. Okay, so what we're doing here, you see this Dow low, this one here on the 120-minute chart at 16,026.61 at 3:30 in the afternoon on the 4th of September. And you see this low on the 1st of September of 15,979. Notice I said 15,009. That's under 16,000. This is why it's very important where we are. For my subscribers, what I said is there is a left side, right side price time match. I was asked if I'd elaborate a little bit on my 1-3-6 rule. And my 1-3-6 rule says in a bull phase or a bear phase, there should be no more than one, preferably one, but it could go up to three bars before a new recovery high is made or recovery low or a new low is made. If you stretch it out, then you can get to six, but six says that you're now in a different phase. A six says 6 days of consolidation or six bars of consolidation suggests that there's not enough strength and that the next move up will be what we call a stair step move. It'll just be real sudden that if you aren't there for the turnaround, you might miss it because, and then by the time it gets there, it starts to pull back. Now, why do I talk about that? I had spoken about the speed of bull phases and the speed of bear phases, and I suggested for at least over a month now, actually more than a month, that what we're in is the Chapman wave, in the Chapman wave methodology, an H pattern that goes to an M, that M that can go to a lowercase M, that is, and what I call a continuous arch formation, whereby there's a larger arch, and then you come back, and the price comes back and retests the left side lows of importance. And now you can see 15,979 right there. Technicals were quite good, not great, but quite good, allowed it to rally back. And two things happened. One is it made one arch, then a couple of little mini arches. I in fact, would like to make that into one arch formation right there from there. It's just, it's not a pretty thing to look at. That's my biggest complaint here. I like things to look artistic, and this is not looking artistic. Okay. And then you get the bigger arch. So that's saying, and I've been talking about this for a long time, that within this formation, the pattern that you can expect is that when that right arm starts to break, this is the right shoulder, so the right shoulder starts to break, that's where the big test comes, because if we close today below 15,970, 79 is actually the low, but below 15,970, that suggests that whoosh, we can go straight down to the Chapman wave Roman candle test of the wick, which is right there at that low bar right there at 15,651. If that 15,600 area is taken out, then immediately you've got to expect that you're going to be heading towards the 15,370 low of August the 24th. I think there's a fooler here. I think that we are. Hey, this is just a trade, and I said to subscribers, for just a trade, we want to buy a long position. At this particular point, it is just within fractions of being taken out. Depends, of course, when you got in, but I said a one-point stop. And I recommended that we get this Because on a very short-term basis, based on the Chapman wave trend indicator, based on the pattern that we've seen, let me show you, let me pull this down here, of the very high volatility in the TRIN, the short-term trading index that was designed by Richard Arms. And what we're looking at in this particular index is that every time it's gone above the fours into the 420, 552, 488, 436, 451 area, there's been a very sharp upside reversal. Why would this be different? Now it comes to my second question that I was asked in an email. And the question was, I have difficulty in the Chapman wave when I expect a D to happen, but it only goes to a C. Where am I wrong? What can I do? What's the rule? Well, the rule is you've got to know your chart patterns, remember? And in this chart pattern, I said there is no rule in the Chapman wave H to an M formation of going to a D. You're looking at a border. You're looking at a boundary. You're looking at a containment area. It feels horrible every day you come in and you're looking at the futures down 30 or up 30. And then they reverse from being up the Dow up 400 to down 200. You got these crazy. But all it's doing is it's trading. And actually, historically, this, let me show you historically. I wonder if this is the chart. Yeah, let me take this chart. This is historically, squeeze it. This is just a narrow range. We've been in a narrow range for from that August 24th low. As soon as we got out of that, the real low was the 15,676. We haven't even been close to that. And the high really has been this high right here of 16,755. And then there was one spike. You remember that was that spike after the Fed announcement that went to 16,933. Wasn't that a week ago? Something like that. So isn't this very interesting? And I drew in the arch formation, which is a tad higher than I expected, but it's still the arch formation. So as I said before, timing-wise, this bar right here, oh, look where we are. I said this bar, we were looking at this bar when I came on the air. And that was the E-minis. They were trading at about 18, I think it was right there, at about 1900, that's what I said. So now we're at 1902. And this is the bar, this is the most important one. Why? Because the 16,000 millennium level is so important, it has so much psychological meaning, I should say. It has so much psychological meaning, it has no contextual meaning in the big time frame and the scheme of things and the bigger chart patterns. It means nothing. It's just a number. But psychologically, if you start to trade in the 15,000s, it's like buying gas at $2.99 instead of $3. It's $3. It sounds like a lot more than $2.99. You remember that's the psychological thing that happened in the 50s when they started pricing in pennies. So this is what we're looking at. An absolutely key moment. Why? Because you don't have to get to a D, although look at this, in the diamonds, you actually went to a peak D in the Chapman wave. So I'll be back and we'll elaborate a little bit more on what the scenario is. Nothing's changed, we're in a bear market. Get that right. I'm thinking of the trading range, when it's really going to break. I'll talk about that. We'll be right back. Dow's down 225.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you like it does me, visit everbank.com/TFNN to find out what they can do for you. Again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. Visit them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Basil, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, folks, we're back. So the TYX, the 30-year T-bond yield, is, look at this. You remember that long-term trend line that I drew across months ago? And I said, hey, this is what we're going to be careful of. Well, look what happened. It went right to that level, and now it's pulling back. The yield is at 28.80. Down 0.61, 2.8, that is, percent. The 10-year T-note is at 2.09%, and 1.42 is the 5-year. Isn't that interesting? And the 5-year note, there's a trend line. Let me just draw this because it's going to be very important for the others that have broken their trend line. This one's in a much narrower trading band, and it says that on the downside, it'll go quite a bit lower if the yield of the 5-year cracks 1.26, and on the upside, it really has to break 1.614. And that'll say, uh-oh, be careful, I'm getting towards the high again. So this is a very important period, number one. Number two is, when you are looking at these patterns, you see that little cluster pattern there? That's the closest to the yields have been in, now what would we call that? That's just the closest they've been. I guess it's the best way to put it. Visually, look, that's the closest. You remember that when the yields were really far apart? And look how close they were together. The only time they've been that close is if you had to go back to, all the way back to, let's do this. Why is that? It's a little slow. There. Okay. If I go back to right there, back to June of 2007 at 5.408. That's where their cluster formation was absolutely the closest. It was almost a yield inversion. And then look what happened. came all the way down, 2.4, 2.2. Things are happening here, and yet the yield basically is in the same trading range. Talking about trading range, look at this. We were in a trading range for a while in the HGX, the Philadelphia Housing Sector Index. Look at this H formation. That is lethal. The week hasn't closed. We've still got tomorrow to go. But if the HGX closes under 220.07, that's trouble. That's real trouble. Because that suggests that the low of the week of the 8th of May at 218.63 becomes a magnet. And you break that, you can get your one-to-one to the extension to the downside. So all of this is really important. So I, in a way, it was kind of dumb, but I really thought it through very carefully this morning, saying, you know what? This is an opportunity to see whether or not the 1600s holds. And I believe that the parameters I put in were real tight, but if they worked, it worked. We've got shorts, we've got longs. It's funny, we've got a long right now that's up 2 cents. It's a $6 stock and it's up 2 cents. Holding very well, only because the market will drag it down if there's another leg down. But at this particular point, it is under the radar. And I think those are the only stocks you can go long, which is the only reason why I want you to go. Hey, just take a jab, because I felt it was too late to go to the short side. There was points to the downside, but unless we break, and I have to tell you, my I don't like to go with gut feeling, because gut feeling, it's all it is, gut feeling. There's no technical veracity or anything. But my sense of the analysis was, we were going to go down, but before we go down deeper, the trading range frustration is going to continue. And you can see that, because this is wood, which is the iShares Global Timber and Forestry ETF. Look how that's been suggesting that if they have a direct relationship to the housing sector, which they should. They've had it before. I don't see why they shouldn't have it still, unless that was all buying from overseas. But my thinking here is that, yeah, it's important for now. And we've gone into alternate count F/B in the weekly chart. It's broken the 46.69 low of the week of the 17th of October of last year in an arch formation. This is serious stuff. So here we are looking at a whole bunch of things. I'm going to grab these charts now because it's other things I want to do, but I wanted to do this. You remember I spoke about UNP and I said, I don't know who did it. I don't know where I got the information from, but someone had said to me a long time ago, look at UNP, Union Pacific Corp, and look at the relationship of Union Pacific Corp to the SPY or the S&P. So I did, and they said every time UNP goes to a new high, the S&P will do that, or vice versa. They work in sync. And then I looked at it and I thought, you know, I'm not going to use this as an indicator. This is what someone told me. I need to see the proof. And it looked like it was great. It was looking. And then all of a sudden, I did a study on it. I'm not sure I can actually find it here. Let me see if I can find it. UNP Weekly, that's not there. That's what we're looking at. Yeah, there it is. Okay, so let's hope that this is the one. I'm going to try to grab it. Is this the one? Yes, I think this is. Oh, excellent. So there it is. Oh, no, that's UUP. Why did I say, UUP? Oh, we got to look at that as well. All right, I'll be back, and we will look at the relationship. But most importantly, look at all these. This is the SPY. This is GE. This is the diamonds. This is the Qs, and this is the IWM. Look, they've all broken key levels of support. I'll be right back. Dow's down 246. S&P's down 26.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry. Powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. We're back. So a couple of things I wanted to do. Well, during the break, I moved away from the topic there. And, of course, now I have to think about what the topic was because once I move away, I move away. But the gold contract, the reason why I got distracted is that the gold contract, you're trading at 11:54, 23. I've got this going back to May of 2001. Really, to say it's upsetting is upsetting. I'm looking at this chart here, and it's at 1200, and it says up 69. And I'm looking at it, and the date is 9/30/15. And I don't understand what's going on. This is the contract that I wanted. If I go to at gco.p. Interesting. Okay, let's just try that. I can't lose anything other than some data. So let's do that. At gc.p. And where does that go back to? And that has us up 100, up 69. I don't know what that is, but there's that chart. And that's the chart that goes way back. This is the chart. Okay, and it goes back to December of 1974. So it's upsetting for a couple of reasons. It's upsetting because I want the very long-term charts as well. So I'm missing data. The pattern actually looks exactly the same. I don't know where they're getting it from. I'm going to try to find that out. But what's really important, the reason why I wanted it, I wanted to show historical context. And most importantly about the historical context, I wanted to show that that bull market that started in, what was it, December 1999, I think. All I remember, the XAU was at 44, and I had a pretty good buy signal on it then. And the XAU today is at, XAU is at 47. Hey, what happened? It went to 232, and now it's back to 47. Yeah, it's back to 47. Wait a minute. Going back to 1999. 41.61. Okay, and I had it, I think it was 40. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I remember typing in 44, and I said, okay, got to remember that number. So in the meantime, back at the ranch, where is gold gone? Where's the XAU gone to? This is the Philadelphia Gold and Silver Sector Index. Well, it's gone to 232.72. I would say that this is a pretty damn big pullback. And that's the thing I wanted to point out, that bear markets can last a lot longer than you think. Bull markets can last a lot longer than you think. What can change this from a bear market to a bull market? Now, I'm looking at the XAU monthly, and the reason why I wanted to bring it up is because I'd seen this chart just recently, and I thought, got to keep that in mind, got to keep it in mind. Why? Look at the MACD, the way the MACD has rallied beautifully off the low, and that low was made right there at about, so MACD, at 6.37 back in December of 2013. The XAU was at between 79 and 86. Now the MACD is at, wait a minute, that's not right. Let me do that again. Yeah, 6.27, that's what I should have said. 6.27, the low in January of 2014. And now the MACD is at 6. Why is that 6.09? I don't understand this. Something's happening. Something's happening that I should know about. Look, that is a low. Oh, that's right. Okay, so I've got it. So that low is at 6.27 right there. No, I don't understand it. No, I don't understand it at all. Look, there's no way that that red line there is higher than that red line there. Because if you draw a trend line, I'm not sure exactly what the calculation is, but I've never seen that before, so I'd have to figure it out. But what I wanted to say is visually, there you are. Visually, this is quite a lot higher. Price is a lot lower. Now, remember we were looking at, just a few months ago, I was looking at the stochastic and the MACD, and what I'd said is that the MACD holding higher means two things. One is there's a lot of room to go down, but at the same time it says, hey, wait a minute, it's holding well, and if there is a rally, there should be a rally that gets the faster moving average, the green line above the red line. But if it flattens out, it limits the upside. Doesn't say you can't go higher, just limits the upside. So this is the same theory here. What I'm looking at is, this is saying, yes, there could be a rally, but limited in the XAU. Maximum would be 47 to the bar, the candle high of kind of 54-ish area, 53 to 55. But if it closes about 53, 55, all of a sudden, for the first time in months, the nine-period exponential moving average at 60.47 comes into view. Believe me, 47 to 60, not a bad gain. But a lot depends on the stochastic turning from 6.36 up into the 9s, 10s, and then the 13s. And that's going to be very important. So I thought there were a couple of things. Technically, this is not Technical Friday, but I just needed to go through those aspects in terms of chart patterns since I brought it up, and I recall that the XAU had done that. Now, another complaint I had is, why should I be getting the very long-term gold contract, slightly different price, same pattern but a different price, and the continuous contract with one that's current today? I don't know. I'll try to figure that one out. So as I'm looking at the XAU, not bad. It's good. Nice divergence between the weekly stochastic and the MACD. Very good move today, 2.63 up almost 6% at 47.24. Still way underneath the high that was made on the 18th. So when I look at the dollar, and I want you to do the comparisons here, as I say, Friday is more technical, but I need to do it. See, the dollar is really in this trading range. You want to recognize chart formations? Look, there's the arch formation. Here's another one. And what did I say? Just 5 days ago, I said, if we break above that red line, the declining line, that declining line becomes the defining line for support. That's just the way it works. I don't know why it works that way. Look, that line, let me just make it so there's a nice transparency here. Let's make it 50% there. So you see that green bar that went right through the resistance in the dollar to 95.98 on the 21st. That said, this is going to be a move that takes, if it goes above 96.62, it starts leg C. Instead, it stopped at 96.55. And now all of a sudden it's pulling back under the 9 EMA. Stochastic's still quite good at 72%, not great, but good. And the MACD is making these M formations, which suggests exactly like you see. The MACD very often imitates, especially the fast moving average, imitates the price. See the move up, that arch, and then a higher level, it starts another arch. Arch and a higher level starts another arch. So this is saying that the dollar is in a trading range. It isn't negative yet. You get these ugly days, but look what happens. Immediately it turns back green. What happens over the next 3 days is really important. Now, I think Yellen's supposed to be saying something today. Oh, this is the week that they were going to make it late because of Yom Kippur yesterday. That's right. So we've got a Fed speak today. I'm still of the opinion, and we'll see what happens, that this is exactly the moment that there should be some kind of a counter trend rally. Could be that Federal Reserve Chairman Yellen says something that the market perceives as at least getting a grip on things. Or maybe she just turns around and says, you know what? I made a big mistake the other day. I shouldn't have said anything about the foreign countries. Things here are 2.35967884692% rise in the economy is really good. After all, look at all the other countries. We are doing great. Don't get upset about things. I want the stock market higher. I want the stock. But things will be improving slowly. But I want the stock market higher. I want the stock market. Who knows? Maybe that's what she's looking at. But believe me, you can't change the tide. The tide says, now let's go back to the tide, INDU. The Dow says that the weekly has made the arch formation. It started it a day earlier than I expected, but that's okay. I'm not the market. I'm only the follower of the market. See that trend line? I was expecting a bounce above it. Now, what's important is that the Dow holds at, what did I say, 16,000, the midpoint was that line right there, 16,979. Start closing under 16,000. Believe me, I think that there will finally be a lot of people getting out of this market. Now look at this. This is the chart that we looked at. Remember, all of these yellow circles gave a really good rally. All of a sudden, that really good rally, well, let's face it, going from 15,370 to 16,933, that's 1,600 points. That's a pretty big rally, but then it starts to fail. But all it's doing really is either the H pattern, or we're going to plummet down and start another big move to the downside. We're making a microcosm of this thing here. And that's what we've got to be careful of. All right? So I don't want to be sanguine. I'm just saying that we're in kind of oversold territory, that there should be a bounce. I have once again the Chapman wave trend gauge flashing that says we should have a 7 to 9 point rally tomorrow. Jeez, they're adding up, aren't they? So now let's go back to our story. S&P. This S&P hasn't even gone close to what it tested the low of the fourth. Oh, just like the Dow. 1911.21. Today's low is 1908.92. The next level of support right there, very important, is 1903.07. Take that out, whoosh, I think we go straight down to the 1860s. So I'm not sanguine at all. I'm looking at this. We do have an opening call. Oh, I want to talk about something. For a very long time, actually it's over a year, but certainly almost all of this year, I feel responsible. I need to take responsibility for it, because I've been talking about the IBB as being probably the linchpin, that if it comes off, the wheels will start to fall off in the Qs and the NASDAQ, the IWM or the Dow, the S&P, because there's so many biotech stocks in those indices. And I, as I say, I'm taking responsibility in the sense that, yes, we were early a number of times, did a lot of trading, but at the same time, and this is the responsibility I'm taking for, is that I did not do it. I started doing it in the Dow for subscribers through the DOG, and I didn't hold that position short all the time, 100% short to the Dow. We've been in and out, made some money, but really the position was there. I wanted to keep it. I've not done that. I feel that was a mistake. Now I'm looking at the IBB, and I think that it is impacting very seriously the other markets. And to go with that, at 322.10, now I have to admit that we are still short from the 393 area, a small position, good. But that candle there, I thought there'd be a little bit of a bounce towards the 340 area, and then we could add to the short position. Instead, it's just continued down, and now that candle becomes a potential halfway marker. Excuse me. And that halfway marker says, if, in fact, you haven't turned around to at least make a bounce, but instead you're sailing down, the most important level to be looking at now, we actually went close to it today, 320.11, is that whole 318 area to the open that was at 312.29 on the 24th. That's going to be very important. Closing underneath the 312 level at any point in the next 2 weeks suggests that the IBB will not only break that major trend line, but it'll start to test the 284 level very quickly. This is not the time to be playing games. If you're in IBB stocks and there's a fabulous bounce coming up in the next few days, please take the opportunity at least to lighten up. I've been saying that all the time. I would much more than lighten up, but I'm just saying, you know, I was wrong for the big move up. I thought earlier on, well, we did get the fabulous move in October. We were part of that. Moved to the downside. But the fact is, wrong. It went higher than I anticipated, and it went to 400.79. So just one person's opinion, but my suggestion is take something off. Don't be vulnerable to a sector that's going into a hat trick top. And believe me, if you think of what the politicians are going to say about the biotechs and about people paying $64,000 for every hours of, you know, they'll make up whatever numbers they want. They're going to impact these stocks. That's my impression. Now, the other thing that I'm looking at as as vulnerable is the XLV, the healthcare itself. I think that S&P Select Healthcare Spider is also, like the IBB, in the process of making a hat trick top. When I say major hat trick top, it means that the daily chart has already given a sell signal. Now, we might be talking a position here because we are short the XLV, but that's not the issue. The issue is there was a peak D way back at 77.40, excuse me, in July. That became a sell mode, and then the weekly went into sell signal, then a sell mode, and August 24th in one day, actually, it went from sell signal to sell mode. And the monthly chart, I've got a down arrow because it's a peak F in the Chapman wave. There could be an alternate count. I just don't know how I could make that an alternate count because that's your D. That can't be A, B because you went way below. All I can say is that I'm pretty darn certain that this is a Chapman wave candle, a Roman candle, that's going to be filled in at some point, and that we've got a Chapman wave two-bar reversal at 77.40 to 77.27 going from July to August. The XLV is the next sector to start coming down. Basil Chapman, we'll be right back.
Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full custom capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Up next, the Diagnostics Trading Hour with Daryl Martin here on TFNN.
Hi, folks. Just real quick, this is the 5-minute E-mini chart. See, there's the peak A, peak B, peak C. But this is the arch formation, two fighting patterns here. There's the up channel, must hold the close in the S&P in the next few minutes below 1900. It's at 1902.25. It says, arch formation coming back down. But a sudden pop to the upside, and if it takes out 1905.50, it says, up until the Yellen speak at 2 o'clock, could move higher. But I bet that right as we're getting into the Yellen, the Fed announcement, the market will just quieten down really quickly. Now, a couple of questions I had. One is about my long-term outlook. Is this the move that's going down that is so serious that it just wipes us out for a long, long time? Or will there be, even if it's in 6 months' time, another major move to the upside to go to new highs? I don't want to just do this arbitrarily. I'm thinking it through because there are a number of scenarios. I have a back of my mind. I have a scenario that I think is going to work out. I'm going to go through it with subscribers this weekend. I will send out charts and I'll be discussing it. It's a complex thing. Let's just say it's complex. And tomorrow in the technical show, I will talk a little more about it. The next question I had is about the SOX. Well, the SMHs. That's a semiconductor index, SMH, is trading right now at 47.95 after a peak E top in the daily. That looks like the arch formation. Question is, I have the person says, I have, like you, I'm negative on the semis. I have the SOXS at a certain price. Is it really worth keeping it? I don't want to go in and out. I'm going to make two suggestions. One is that you hold it and you just hold it, because that semiconductor index, I think, is going down to the 44s. It's going to retest the August low. That's number one. Number two is, if you want, you could put a tighter stop on your SOXS on a portion, but keep a chunk. That's just the way that probably is the safest way. Personally, at the entry point that you got in, I would hold it. I'd at least hold it for the next few days. So that's that. Now, the next question about in the den is the TLT. Well, in the long-term perspective, this is leg C in the dailies, leg C in the TLT Lehman 20-year T-bond fund at 123.17. I see to subscribe a close over the 123.90s is really what's needed, because then you've got 124.85 is the 200-period simple moving average in the daily. But what it's saying is that rallying like this, if you look at the DOG, let me just see the DOG, leg AB, this is a leg C. If you look at the let's just go SDOW, this is 300% short. It's also leg. The way I'm looking at this, we are that 1600 level on the Dow is absolutely imperative. By the end of the day or tomorrow, if we close under it, it can be a real quick swing to the downside. That's number one. Number two is I believe that the play in bonds is still active. The weekly and monthly so far, still got another week to go or more in the monthly chart, but it's saying that at worst, we're in a narrow trading range. At best for bonds is that if the market breaks that into the 15,900, 800, 700, 600, it keeps going down, bonds are going to move higher. So that's the answer to it is, where is the LTLT, a short sale? I'd give it another day or two, because you'd have to get an arch formation and you want to time it perfectly, because it's a dangerous game to be playing the short side of bonds only because of this market situation. So let me do it real quickly. The Fed, the Fed's going to be afraid to do anything. Well, what are they going to do? I don't want to get into it. I think that right now the bonds are saying money's flowing out of stocks into bonds. Let's leave it at that. I'll deal with it a little bit more tomorrow. That's for the day. You've got a great show coming up. Stay tuned for Daryl shows all the way through. I'm just going to say the VIX index actually should be way higher. It's at 24.10. If by the end of the day it takes out 26.29, the high of the 22nd of September, this market is going way lower. If it's at 22.30, market bounces.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
This is TFNN.